Good evening again from Louisiana. Even though we knew it was coming, the numbers are still shocking to hear. Just a few hours ago, the federal government raised its official estimate of how much oil has been gushing into the Gulf for weeks now. They now estimate 20 to 40,000 barrels are spewing out every single day. 20 to 40,000. Now that's double the estimate they made just a few weeks ago. 4 to 8 times the estimate they made a few weeks before that, and 20 to 40 times larger than BP's original estimate. And even this new estimate may be very low, according to scientists working for the government to analyze the actual flow rate. They'll likely have a new estimate tomorrow or maybe early next week. What does BP say about this new estimate, and how do they explain their ridiculously low estimates early on? Well, here's the statement they made today, and I quote, BP fully supported this effort, providing the scientific team with data, including a considerable amount of high-resolution video. We have made no estimate of the flow rate ourselves. Now, let's just look at this statement for a moment. They say they fully supported the effort to measure the flow rate. Let those three words just sink in for a bit. BP, fully supported. Does fully supported mean not releasing underwater video of the leak for weeks until the government lawmakers forced them to? Because that's what happened. And when they did release that video, it was only a 30-second clip. Does fully supported mean withholding high-resolution HD video from at least one of those scientists and Congress and the public until just a few days ago? Because that's also what happened. Does fully supported mean not allowing scientists working for the government to actually directly measure the gusher of oil? Because that is still happening right now. Now, in that statement, BP also said, quote, we have made no estimate of the flow rate ourselves. Now, you can interpret that two ways. They could mean we've never bothered to try to measure the flow rate, and that's absolutely true. But why they've never bothered to do that is hard to comprehend. I mean, how do you know how to put out a fire unless you know how big the fire is? But they could also have meant by that statement that they've never committed themselves to claiming to know the flow rate, that they've never pretended to know the actual flow rate. And that is simply not true. Keep it in mind, here are just a few examples of them estimating the flow rate.
We think that the range has increased of what the estimate has been. So I think that somewhere between 1 and 5,000 barrels a day is probably the best estimate we have today.
You're sticking with approximately 5,000 barrels a day?
I think that's a good range. I don't know the precise number, but I think it's somewhere around that number, and that's been both our estimate and that of the unified command that government agencies were working with.
The 5,000 barrels a day, we've always said, an estimate all of us came together to make. We've always said it's highly, highly uncertain.
Your company continues and the government continues to use this 5,000 barrels a day figure, which is really a three-week-old estimate made from satellite images by NOAA. Why are you still using that figure?
Because it looks like the best estimate from the surface response and the plume that we see at the base of the well itself.
It sounds like they've been pretty insistent on giving out very public and very low estimates of the flow rate, even after independent scientists said the real rate was much, much higher. By the way, that's the one interview I've ever been allowed to do with a BP official. After that interview, they've never talked to me again. By the way, shortly after releasing that statement, BP re-released it. Only this time they erased the last sentence, claiming they've made no estimate of the flow rate ourselves. So they cut that sentence out. So in addition to putting out one statement that pretty much airbrushes history, they then put out a second statement which airbrushed the first statement. Tonight, and always, we're keeping them honest, and we have a lot to cover and uncover tonight. James Carville on why he believes the government is still not treating this with more urgency. We're going to hear from the people who lost loved ones on the Deepwater Horizon who met with President Obama today. Some of them say they have not heard a single word from BP. Not a call of sympathy, not even a card. We're also going to dig deep into BP's safety record, though, frankly, we didn't have to dig much to come up with several red flags. And we'll show you the ways the reporters are now being blocked from showing you pictures of oiled birds being brought in. Oh, and remember the letter that we got yesterday, BP claiming they've never told their employees they can't speak to reporters? Well, today we put that claim to the test. We begin, though, with one of the members of the government's flow rate team, a scientist, right now working round the clock to come up with an accurate estimate of exactly how much oil is flowing. A scientist who told us days ago he'd only just received the high-resolution HD pictures of the leaking well, and who says BP has not been forthcoming with information and critical data for a long time. We spoke earlier tonight. Professor Leifer, did you ever believe the numbers that BP was putting out early on, the 1,000 barrels a day figure, even the 5,000 barrel a day figure?
Neither of those figures ever seemed realistic, especially from looking at how the oil spread over the sea surface so rapidly and into such an extensive area. Those numbers were clearly low balls, significant low balls.
Do you think BP believed those numbers?
It's hard for me to know what BP believes or not. On the other hand, since they're not realistic, if they believed them, they were just believing in a dream.
I mean, has BP made it easy for you to study this leak? You're still in the process of analyzing video, of trying to study this leak. Have they given you the access that you need?
Until very recently, they were extremely obstructionist, making it very difficult, if not impossible, for us to do our work.
Why do you think they've made it difficult for you to do your work? I mean, you are tasked by the U.S. government to get accurate numbers, and now the U.S. government is saying this is the most important thing to know the size of this leak.
It's a good question, and I think it doesn't make a lot of sense. What I really wish BP would understand is that having good numbers is in their interest too, because so far to date they've been trying solution after solution, and they've been failing one after another. And I think one of the reasons why is that no one really knows how much oil is coming out, and so things have been playing dice that we won't have another catastrophe on our hands.
You would like to be able to directly measure the flow rate, actually, you know, put instruments down there to try to actually measure the rate. Is BP, they're not allowing that. Do you know why?
I have to assume that after this many weeks, the reason underlying is they don't really want anyone to know what the numbers are. However, if they don't know the numbers, then how do they know that their relief wells will not make things worse, possibly much worse? Even the video analysis that we have, we have to make assumptions. We can't see into the plume. We don't know what's inside that oily plume. If we actually could make measurements, we'd know. We wouldn't be guessing. And BP has gotten in this problem because they did not do things safely. And I think this is just another example of them not following the proper procedure so that the efforts to stop this horrible incident are done in a safe manner.
Congressman Markey has written them asking them to allow you to directly measure. You're probably going to have new numbers coming out in the next couple of days. And in the past, you said, I mean, this could be much higher. Right now, these numbers of up to 40,000 barrels, it could be way more than that, correct?
I can't really talk about the video that we're analyzing, but what I can talk about, what I see streaming, for example, on CNN right now on your feed, they're capturing 18,000 barrels, and the plume looks more or less the same as before they started capturing the oil. So clearly there's a lot more oil coming out of this leak at this moment. And I'd like to point out that even if the number today was 50,000 or whatever, there's no guarantee tomorrow it would not be something worse. This is a moving target.
Professor Leifer, I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Again, it's important to remember Professor Leifer is not just some guy we put on TV. It's not somebody who's just kind of watching this casually. This is the man tasked by the U.S. government, one of many scientists, to actually study the flow rate. And he is just getting high-resolution HD video of this. I mean, this is day 52 we're talking about. This is critical information, important to hundreds of thousands of people, watched by people around the world. And he says that BP has not been giving him the information for weeks now that he and other scientists need. President Obama coming down here next Monday and Tuesday, not to Louisiana, but to other states, Alabama, Mississippi, and Florida. Mr. Obama has invited top BP officials, including the company's chairman, Carl Henrik Svanberg, to the White House on Wednesday. Sense of urgency seems to be growing in Washington, though people down here are still less than happy about the sense of urgency here in the Gulf. James Carville and I talked about that and the new higher flow numbers just released earlier. We taped this a few hours ago during daytime. So now this flow rate group has come out with a higher estimate. It's not a surprise to you. I remember when I told you the new estimate was 12 to 19,000 weeks ago, you said, and it's going to go higher still. It's still going to go higher because, I mean, there's this other flow rate group which says it could be as high as 100,000, and they're still crunching the numbers.
Yeah. And